Merry Christmas, everybody. My name is Sean, and welcome to the EA Holly Jolly Christmas Show. Now, what goes oh, oh, oh? Santa Claus walking backwards. Ha ha, but enough about me. It's not about me, seriously. It is all about our family support and educational programs. That's why we have a QR code on the bottom of your screen right now for you to scan, and also a link for you to click on. So a little bit of your giving will really go a long way, and this is the reason we have this entire show in the first place, for you to support all these amazing kids, alright? So keep doing it and keep watching. Thank you so much for your time. And what is Christmas without a little drinky drinks, right? So I'm gonna learn how to make a very special drink over here. Follow me. And welcome to Quinton's. I'm here with Quinton. And today we're gonna make a very special drink. It's called the Jinkly Nona. And Quinton, you wanna demonstrate how it's done?
Alright. So first we start off with gin.
What's the inspiration behind the Jinkly Nona?
What I wanted to do was create a European mix of European flavors. So we have gin, English gin, we've got Portuguese port, and of course Dutch peach liqueur.
Okay. I also know the Jinkly Nona is a dance, right?
Yes. So that is why we played it with a bit and call it Jinkly Nona, as in gin.
Okay. Because that's why I realized the spelling is a little bit different. Now I get it. So this drink was created to celebrate our 100 years or something like that, right?
Yep. For the Eurasian Association celebration of the 100 years.
Oh, it looks beautiful.
Just a dash of soda. There we have it. Jinkly Nona.
You make it look so easy. Now I have to learn all that. Bear in mind, I have no experience behind the bar whatsoever. Most of my time is spent in front of the bar for many hours. But this is my first time behind the bar, so yeah. Walk me through everything step by step. So this for everybody watching at home, if you have, you know, everything you need, you can make this at home for Christmas as well.
Alright, so first we start off with 30 ml. This is a jigger.
Okay. So gin first, right?
Yeah, gin.
30 ml. Ooh, look at that. Okay.
So that's 30 ml.
And then?
60 ml of port.
So two times of this. Yeah. Okay. So yeah, not so good in math, but drinks, I understand. How long have you been cooking?
For the past 20 years.
20 years, that's how old I am. Uh-huh. Slightly older, but don't tell
more
people.
Or less, plus minus 10.
Plus minus 10. And this is 30 ml as well?
30 ml. Just maybe about 60 ml of lime juice. Don't have to measure, just.
Don't have to measure, I must measure. Like, everything I do must measure. And so. So speaking of measuring, you mentioned that you have like what, 20 years experience cooking. How did you start?
I started in 2000 with my dad at Changi Business Park. It was a food court. I was there for about 8 years. After 6 years down there, I opened my first restaurant at East Coast Road.
Okay, yes, I remember.
1 year later, we moved to the Eurasian Association.
But you have a very nice place here. You guys should come and visit if you haven't already. So everything's in here, like an urn. And what do I do next?
Shake.
Okay. This one, okay, also got it. Is this better? Oh. This is what I see bartender friends do. It's very cold. My hands are freezing. Is it supposed to be that cold?
Remove the top.
Remove the top.
And then pour into the glass.
Pour into the glass.
Maybe about halfway.
Look at that pour, lah. I was born to do this.
Okay. And then now you put in the...
Okay, a little bit of the...
Lemon. Wet.
A tad of mint.
Yes. And then...
The same way?
Yeah.
This is a dried lemon peel, I believe. A little bit more ice to cover it.
So just dash. If you want to add the rest, you can add the rest. Not too much, and then just a dash of soda.
Alright, so add a little bit more on top. And a dash of soda water.
And that's it, we're done.
Alright, look at mine. How awesome is this? Actually, yours looks nicer, I don't know. Lucky you're getting paid to do this. It's all about presentation, right? So I know, like, normally people or chefs or, you know, people that own restaurants, they don't get asked this question a whole lot. From your entire menu, right, which one's your favorite?
Whenever I eat curry devil, right, it just reminds me of Christmas. So obviously I'll have the curry devil and then the pot roast beef, you know, things like that. And it just takes me back to Christmas every time.
Who's the biggest celebrity you've ever cooked for?
I don't remember his name though.
So okay lah, not that big lah, apparently.
It was a famous guitarist or something like that.
Slash, let's just say Slash.
No lah, not Slash.
Slash came to the EA and he had a little bit of Quentin's magical juice cheers. No.
Okay.
Yeah. See, now you must drink your own creation, right? I must taste test like this one. I like.
How do you find it?
Nice. Sweet. With that little peachy taste at the end, I like it. I can definitely make this by myself already.
Very refreshing.
Yeah. So thank you so much for your time.
Thank you, Quentin.
Thanks everybody for watching as well. Remember to scan the QR code at the bottom of your screen and click on the link below, because we want to raise funds to assist our family support and educational programs. A little bit of your contribution goes a long way. Thank you very much. So welcome to our Getting to Know segment, and I have two very serious adults here. Isabella and Christian. Isabella is a fashion designer and Christian's a lumberjack, as you can tell. Is that right?
No.
Then what do you guys do? How old are you guys?
I'm 10 years old.
I'm 7 years old.
And what do you guys do?
I like to play football.
Okay, you like to read. What's your favorite book?
Dog Diaries.
Dog Diaries, alright. And you like to play football. Who's your favorite player?
Ronaldo.
Alright, that's my favorite player as well. Good job. What's your favorite color? Let's get to know you a little bit better.
Orange.
My favorite color is purple.
Alright. And what's your favorite Eurasian dish?
My favorite Eurasian dish is suji cake.
Why suji cake?
Because my nanny makes the best. Oh. And I love it very much.
And yours, you were saying?
My favorite Eurasian dish is beef schmaltz.
Why?
Because my papa makes it. It's the best.
Okay, I'm sure all these are answers your parents told you, one, but never mind, it's very good. I like the answers as well. Okay, so what's your favorite part about Christmas?
Opening presents.
That's my favorite part too.
Putting up the Christmas tree with my family.
Oh, beautiful. So we've moved to a point where we want to put the two of you to go against each other. It's a competition. Okay, I'm going to ask you three questions. Let's see who get the most points. Okay, question number one. What's a typical Eurasian Christmas dish? A. Shepherd's pie or B. Chicken rice?
Shepherd's pie.
She got it. Okay. Both of you get 1 point. Be fair. Okay, both of you got 1 point. Question number two. Name the Eurasian family on the TV show Kin.
The Shelleys.
Wow, I didn't even have time to give you the options. Okay, let's give you that point as well. What are you guys planning to do tomorrow for Christmas?
Yeah.
That's a great answer. So let's wish everybody at home a very Merry Christmas. 1, 2, 3. Merry Christmas!
I'm walking around, feeling free, thinking about what's happened to me from July. Up till now, don't know where, don't know how. Lately I've...
Sorry, didn't see you there. Are you guys enjoying the show so far? Remember, we're doing all this to assist our family support and educational programs. So a little bit of your giving will go a long way. The QR code on your screen, scan that. The link at the bottom of your screen, click that and help everyone out. And we want to celebrate right now with a special musical number done by Cassandra Spikerman. This is I Saw Mommy Kissing Santa Claus, something every dad wishes they never heard.
See me creep downstairs to have a peek.
Hi everyone, I hope you and your family are well as we count down to Christmas. I also hope you have enjoyed our Holly Jolly Christmas special with musical performances, Christmas recipes, and listening to our amazing kids from the Eurasian community. This has been a challenging year for all, and we hope this Christmas series has brought some cheer and joy to you. At the same time, we wanted to use this opportunity to raise funds to assist our family support and education programs. This will go a long way to help improve the lives of the underprivileged in our community. You can scan the QR code at the bottom of the screen for more information on how you can make a contribution. With that, I would like to wish everyone a Merry Christmas and Happy Holidays. Cheers to a new year.
So there you have it, folks. Thank you so much for joining us. Thank you for viewing every single part of the video. And remember, we're doing all this for our family services and educational programs that the EA has to offer. So if you haven't scanned that QR code, if you haven't clicked the link down below, what are you waiting for? Do it right now. Have a very Merry Christmas. My name is Sean, and it's been a pleasure.